Right. Hey, I sort of would like to share a few things. Got a few things in the last couple days. Been out trying to do some more project doing things instead of shopping. But I do have to share a few things because I'm so stoked about something that I recently received. And I just wanted to sort of give you guys some thoughts to think about where you can get some digital inspiration from. I think two of my favorite mixed medium art types of inspired people are two people, and I have had the honor of at least meeting one. I hope to meet the second one someday. First person I want to talk a little bit about is a gentleman called Nick Bantock. He has probably been the first person that I can really say really got me into mixed medium. It started out late 90s, early 2000 area by having him do some books. And I'm going to just sort of show you these books real quick. This is sort of on a different tangent from most videos that are posted. But I did want to give you a heads up on some of the things that I do have. Nick is, I believe he's from Canada, if I'm not mistaken. He has actually won many prizes and has done some work and actually made some products for Ranger in the past. And I do have all the pads and colors that he did make in the past for Ranger. They were on the market only a very brief period of time. They're in tins. They're sort of similar to Tim Holtz as far as the size of the tins were going. But what was unique about Nick was he believed in taking mixed medium and writing books and stories with it. And he wrote several books. I'm just going to sort of hold up some of them. I don't believe I have his whole collection, but he has won several prizes for these. What is really unique about it, whenever I'm stuck and get in a groove and cannot come up with new ideas on what to really do, I pull one of these books out for inspiration. And these books are really good because he writes the story, but he creates art as he does it. And I am very privileged because I did meet him several years ago. I believe in Cleveland. He was at a stamping convention they have every year. I can't think what it's called right now, but he was able to actually autograph a couple of my books. And I just sort of wanted to show you briefly the books. Like I said, this is a whole different tangent of artwork that you can do with your stamps and different mixed medium, your forum and things like that. As you can see there, he did sign it. I'll pull it up for you. What's really unique about Nick's work is he makes a story. And his story is basically correspondence back and forth from several people. And they tie them all in together. You never know if it's truth or fantasy or what. But sometimes there's a little love stories in it involved with it. And what's great about it is he literally will take old postcards, stamp over them, write new things about them. And for instance, like this is a card he made. And it goes into like a love letter. And the calligraphy and the writing on these letters is just unbelievable. But this is based on a character called Sabine, and she writes to Matthew. And they actually end up falling in love. So if it is ever a dry time and spell when I cannot come up with things, I'll pull out his books. And these books are really unique the way they're done because he has envelopes. So these are like little mini albums in a way. But he puts like the letters inside of the envelopes. And it's like their correspondence back and forth. He started me into the mixed medium. You can just see his artwork is just unbelievable. He has actually written, like I said, several books, won a lot of awards. He also made several stamp sets. I do have them, of course. I did not dig them out to actually show you, but just to show some of the ladies that you don't have to be in the groove to do the same thing over and over. You can go into other directions with what you want to do. Needless to say, I should have Googled to see if he has done anything lately. I'm not sure. He had been ill. I still hope he's with us. I'm not sure he is, but I have not actually seen anything. But these books, like I said, are little mini albums in itself. A lot of envelopes, a lot of postcards in between. He actually put out postcard series. He did a lot of other things. This, I'm sure, someone named Bono would probably enjoy. It's all about Paris. And he had a contest at that point in time. And then this was another book. So it is called The Griffin and Sabi Trilogy. And I just wanted to sort of give you a heads up on that. This is one of the other boxes. He used to do cards and different things like that. And this is all some of his work. These are all postcards that pull out. And just to show you what you can do with your tag art and stuff like that, just to give you some ideas and some thoughts, is what I go back to this over and over for. Reason this came up is because most people talk about Tim Holtz. I love Tim Holtz. I think he's phenomenal. He has gone in a different direction, but he just reminds me so much of Nick Bantock. I wish Nick Bantock would have kept going in the direction Tim Holtz are going, because I think everybody would just absolutely love his products. So this is the purpose of the video. I got my copy of Tim Holtz's new book, Compendium of Curiosities, and yes, he did sign it, and it does say Be Curious 2010. So this is really nice, because almost all of his techniques that he does show on his videos, on his blog, and on his cards are pretty well in here, but it's also up to date because it's using a lot of his new products that he has coming out. So these are just really good things. If anybody's ever in a rut and they don't know what to do or how to do things, or they want to do something new, these are some thoughts to do and to give you some inspiration. So I think that's all I wanted to say. I'm going to be following up shortly, because I also have some hauls, some heads up on some things that people may want to be listening to. Thanks. Bye.